I left India in 1989 to the United States, and after my studies and working, they moved to UAE in 1995. I have seen that country of UAE come from nothing to become one of the best infrastructure cities in the world. Dubai, as everyone knows. And it happened because of one, the great leadership of the ruling family. I came to India to do social work and social entrepreneurship because I was in the oil and gas business. I sold the business for $1 billion in 2012 and came to India to do a lot of social work with the governments. I come from God's own country, Kerala. I'm born there. So my responsibility was to help the government to set up government schools and modify government schools and hospitals. And I was looking at the possibility of setting up a very sophisticated manufacturing park for construction, because India's biggest challenge, we are a growing country, building hospitals and schools and hotels and IT buildings, it takes too long. And we were looking for places to set up this industry. So we started the first one near Bangalore, that is Krishnagiri, in Tamil Nadu. Heard a lot about Honorable Minister Kati Rama Rao. He is young, dynamic. Many people told me many good things. When I spoke to him in Dubai, and I normally, you know, ministers are so busy, they don't have the time to meet. He said, no, I'm here, you know, we are supposed to meet. I'll invite you to come to Hyderabad and see what we are doing, and we would like to invite you to Hyderabad to set up a facility over here. I came in last night. I saw a bit yesterday and today. I met him today afternoon, and I want to just tell you, it is not just for the media, and I'm a person who likes to share what I feel. Everything is based on a leadership, and I've seen Sheikh Mohammed very closely. He's been my partner, and I wanted to tell in front of all of you that is one of a great leadership quality, a leader I've seen, which can make Hyderabad and state of Telangana a better Dubai, I would say, because it's Dubai is built by Indians, and the ruling family acknowledges that all the time. And whenever I come back, I always wonder, why can't we become like them? And I'm pretty confident that we wanted to play a role, and we wanted to do this in Hyderabad, because Hyderabad has got everything. It's an intellectual capital, you know, I think, more than Bangalore, because Bangalore is too crowded and everyone wants to move their bases over here. A lot of people, NRIs in the United States from here, a lot of wealth in this country. And we are very proud to announce this project here. We have decided today, and I take immediate decisions, to invest 650 crores in this very sophisticated manufacturing parks for manufacturing building materials and manufacturing buildings. What we do here is we use technology to manufacture components of the building. We'll have many factories and come and assemble on the site. And that is one of a kind in the world. Not many people have thought about it, because to India to build, you know, 30, 40 million houses, 3 million hospitals, we need to move into the technology space, making all these things to happen. So this is going to be very exciting. It is also going to bring many other industries into Hyderabad and the surrounding areas, and also to develop the whole infrastructure faster. It can be used for bridges, it could be used for the other infrastructures like sewerage treatment plants, drinking water facilities, and whatever people take 24 months, we can do it in 4 to 6 months using our technology. So we are happy to be here with you under your leadership, and I'm pretty confident, because it's all about instinct. And what I get that instinct is, Hyderabad is going to be the darling of our country. And I think that you will show the way, and I think others will follow. And I think we need great leadership like yours, sir, I think. And I wish you all the best, and we will do all of what we can do to support you. Thank you. And many Indians who have a lot of industries in Abu Dhabi, Dubai and Sharjah, and many of them wanted to come back and do investments in India. So we have this Indian Business Professional Council. Now they have created a corpus, Navdeep Singh Suri is part of that, around $1 billion. Okay, and so what we are going to do is, once this announcement has already been done now, we will be attracting many small and medium scale industries of Indians coming over here, because this is something which we discussed, and Ms. Suri came to my factory and he said, Faisal, it's very easy now because we are the anchor and all these people are already there in UAE. So we are going to bring many people, NRIs from the Middle East, to come and invest along with us here. Well, into 650 crores. I would say, I mean, you know, manufacturing attracts the largest investment in any part of the world. You ask me a number which can go up to maybe 5,000 to 6,000 crores, because this is going to grow big. And I've seen many free zones. I had a free zone factory in Jebel Ali, Hamriya, Ras Al Khaimah. One anchor client can attract so much of investments. And so I'm pretty confident it'll be in thousands of crores in the next few years to come. In the building materials, a lot of new materials have come, composite materials which last longer life. So I think we need to really focus on the technology in the manufacturing. And that is what this park will be, very unique, not just in India. In fact, we can make it unique in the world. And we can attract technologies from all over the world to India, because everyone is waiting in the queue to come and invest in our country. All we need is, again I repeat, great leadership, great infrastructure. The money will come automatically.